Hello and welcome to episode 5 of the Something Awful Game Dev Survival Challenge. I'm your host, Zestin. And we are coming back from a very interesting episode 4 in which our heroes or challengers or whatever you want to call them got a once-in-a-lifetime chance to meet the infamous Johnny Five Aces. And he gave them a special item that allowed them to, well, bring Noemi out of the Exile Tower. So she's back with us. Hooray. How about that? We also had a Fireman's Will challenge that nobody won because all of our Sims are too inept. And the maid took care of the fire before anybody could get to it. So the maid won. Tell you what, if there's ever a maid in our survival challenge, she will be OP. So, yeah, this episode, I actually discovered something, finally. So, just about every episode, I've talked about how I need to change the Exile Tower, because Sims who aren't in it frequently try to sleep in there, or eat in there, or, you know, whatever. And then, actually, Sims that are in it will see food in the kitchen over here, and, well, they'll sense it somehow, magically, because they're Sims. And they'll want to get out and go get it, but they can't because there's no stairs. So instead of just, like, deciding to do something within their bounds, they stomp on the floor and complain and whine. Well, it turns out that I've been... And I've watched my previous episodes here, so I know that I've been doing this religiously, but I have no reason... I have no idea what the reason is behind my OCD unlocking of this door. If any of you have been paying any attention at all and been screaming at me saying, man, why don't you just lock that door? That will keep people from complaining. Well, I had no idea until I was trying some things the other day. And yeah, so if I lock this door to everyone, which it is right now, it's like it doesn't even exist. And the people inside the Exile Tower will stick to stuff inside, and the people outside the Exile Tower will stick to stuff outside. In fact, I could even put a set of stairs here if I really wanted to. I'm not going to, because I'm... who cares? And they would continue to ignore it. So, we fixed it. Didn't have to build the Exile Tower somewhere else. We can leave it on the lot. And continue to play, and people should not be upset about the fact that they can't go in there, or they can't go out. So, yeah. Let's get right into things here, and go ahead and hit play. We can see Everdred's taking a shower, fixing up his hygiene, which is surprising coming from Everdred, considering he can live with that. Let's see. We should have, how many Sims do we have? I guess 4 remaining, right? Because me and Turdbot are in the Exile Tower, and yes, we have 4 left now. Oh, John Turp, way to go. You clogged the toilet. Well, let's hope that the maid fixes that. Because if not, well, someone else will have to fix it. We'll wait and see until morning. It's technically, I've been starting these episodes a little too early because it's evening. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward here. It's evening of Sunday. This episode is going to technically really only cover Monday and Tuesday. We'll fast forward through that. Oh, hey, how about that? I saw the immunity gnomes move. How fun. Looked like they kind of faded out and faded back in. That was kind of neat. So go ahead and fast forward some more here. Hopefully, I keep adjusting my speakers because I don't want it to echo through my microphone. Now, remember how yesterday we had a special event and all the game dev challengers got to meet Johnny Five Aces? Well, today's no different. We've set up something special for them. This time we have an actual time at 10 a.m. Oh, hey, it's automatically fast-forwarding for me. I better keep an eye on that. Everybody's asleep. A rare moment where everyone in the Something Awful Game Dev Survival Challenge is asleep. Because there's enough beds and they're not trying to sleep in the Exile Tower. How about that? How about that? This could have saved us so much time. Anyway, at 10 o'clock sharp, we're going to head out and visit someone new. We're going to go find some new neighbors. So that should be, I'm actually kind of excited about this. Yeah. So we'll do that at 10 o'clock. And we'll have an interesting day. So let's just keep fast forwarding here, because we don't really care about the exile people unless they start turning red. These are the four people we care about now. These are the four survivors. They're all that's left. And they will slowly be whittled down over the next few days to one. The one. The chosen one. The Something Awful Game Dev Survival Challenge Champion. Looks like Floofy's getting a bright and early breakfasty morning. Looks like John Turp is getting another bright and early breakfasty morning. Noemi's up. And of course, Everdred is still asleep. I know I've mentioned this before, but it's going to be pretty interesting as we whittle down the contestants. This is really the first we've seen of it. Partly because we locked that Exile Tower door, but partly because there's only four contestants left. We're going to see them actually able to do things like, you know, use the bathroom or take a shower or sleep or eat without running into, you know, two or three other Sims that are all trying to do the same freaking thing. And I think that'll be kind of nice for them and just for us in general, so we don't have to sit and watch that and yell at the screen and try and get them to do things that they aren't going to do. So we've got about an hour left until 10 a.m. Looks like almost everybody's awake. Everdred should wake up here in just a moment. So he'll be awake and ready to go on our little journey. I like how as soon as he woke up, his mood just shot down. That's pretty funny. Okay, we got half an hour left here until our event. Exciting times. John Turp's having a bad day. That's not good, John Turp. It's 10. Okay, so I'm pausing it. Now, I did this before the game. So let me see here. If you don't want spoilers, go ahead and avert your eyes, but I'm going to go ahead and scroll over here to the place we're going, and yeah, it looks like it worked. So continue averting your eyes as I'm going to have our little group go somewhere. Just give me one second here. We got Floofy, John Turp, Noemi, and then Everdred. Okay, so they are all set to go. Now you can bring your eyes back to the screen. We are back in business. When I unpause this, they should head out to our new friends. So let's do that. Let's follow whoever gets there first. Let's go with Floofy. She's gonna come over the hill here, and I have some appropriate music for this event. Let's just wait until we can get it in our sights here. We're getting close. Where do you guys think we're gonna visit today? Oh, I can see it in the distance. Oh, man, those are some weird looking plants. And who's that standing in front? Oh, there's like slides and water and mushrooms and green. We just went over a green hill. This looks kind of like a zone. Uh-oh. It's Sanic the Hog Hedge! And look at that, it's his friend is here too. Knuckles the Dickhegna. Awesome. Oh, we get to see Sanic today. And yesterday it was Johnny Five Aces, and now it's Sanic the Hog Hedge and Knuckles the Dickhegna. How crazy. Oh, what a day. This would be really exciting for our little group of four. Now, this might seem kind of silly. actually, you know what, I have to make one of them ask to be let in. As weird as that sounds, someone has to ring the doorbell on this non-existent house. Yeah, it doesn't make any sense, but that's how this game works. This game is filled with things that make no sense, but once you figure it out, it works. Oh man, Knuckles thinks Floofy Squirp is okay. Well, anyway, so like I said, there's actually a reason for this. We aren't just here to see Knuckles and Sanic. We're here, because there is a prize at the end of this little meet and greet. So yeah, they get to stay here at Sanic and Knuckles's until, what do I have written here? What's the rule? 9 p.m. If they leave on their own, then that's fine. They can do that. If Sanic or Knuckles sends them away, then they have to go. I'm not going to turn them around. And if someone's here at 9 p.m., then I'll just send them back home. Once everybody gets back home, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at that relationship tab. And the Sim who has the highest, who has Sanic highest in their list. Okay, and now let me just explain something real quick without clicking it to give anything away. Sometimes acquaintances just show up at the top of the list. Friends show up later in the list. And so you may have seen in previous episodes how that may have affected, it didn't really affect the vote, but you may have seen someone on the top of the list that had a lower relationship score than someone else. That's why. That's because it's just a new friend that hasn't officially been added to the list yet. But in this case, they should have enough time to make friends. You know, they're going to enjoy a couple drinks here, maybe do a little exercise. I don't know. Yeah, let's check out Knuckles. Knuckles the Dekedna. He's just hanging out with Everdred and Floofy Scorb. Oh, but anyway, yeah, so the rules here. Once they get home, so the person with Sanic as the highest relationship in their list will get a prize. And the Sim who has Knuckles as the highest in their relationship tab will get a real good prize. Well, I think it's real good. Maybe with 4 or 3 or 2 members remaining, it might not be as impressive of a prize, but it's good nonetheless. So we're just going to let them hang out here until 9 p.m. And yeah, so here, let me just show you a little bit of what we got. We got Sanic here preparing a mixed drink, as Sanic likes to do. I thought maybe he'd make some chili dogs, but no, he's just... He gets drunk, he makes mixed drinks, and he screams at his guests. So yeah, Sanic, you know, they live together, yeah. These guys, Sanic and Knuckles. Wait, hold on a second, let me pause this. What's this? Repo Man? Maybe we better go check this out real quick. Let's... Oh, okay, he just left. Oh, I wonder what he took. Let's take a peek around and see if he took anything obvious, anything important. The shower's still there, beds, a toilet, all the kitchen stuff. Doesn't look like he took anything. He must have taken something out of the Exile Tower. Doesn't look like he took anything vital out of there. The kitchen stuff is really the most important thing. It looks like all the beds are there. Bathroom, shower, it's all there. Maybe the Repo Man didn't take anything. Okay, well, let's head back over to Sanic. Sanic and Knuckles. So we got John Turp, who has told Noemi that wealth and riches is all that matters to him, and that she can call him anytime. I don't know what that means, but there you go. So it looks like nobody is actually hanging out with Sanic and Knuckles. We have Everdred and Noemi throwing the ball that got Noemi out of the Exile Tower back and forth with each other, and John Turp's just kind of awkwardly standing by the wall. Floofy, there we go, she's finally having a little chat with Sanic as they have a couple of drinks. That's good on them. Way to hang out with Sanic. Oh, and Knuckles is joining in on the fun while John Turp makes a mixed drink in the background. Oh, what great fun that everyone should be having. Oh, I hope the music in the background is not too loud. I only have like 4 tracks set up for this because, you know, I'm silly, but whatever. Oh, look, Sanic! We have so much in common, I'd love to get to know you better, he says to Floofy Scorp. How sweet. How sweet. Look, they just want to be friends with her. He just wants to use the bathroom. Oh, shit. I built this whole thing, and I forgot to put in a bathroom or a bathroom or a shower or anything. That's pretty funny. Well... That's okay, we're only going to be here for a few more hours. People can stink if they want to. You know, these, I'll tell you what, Everdred and Noemi are, they're not doing the right thing here. It's too bad he has that ball and that they wanted to play with it, because they should really be doing what Floofy Scorp's doing right now. These prizes are not mutually exclusive. If one person has Sanic and Knuckles as the highest person on their relationship list, that person gets both prizes, so... This could be a bad sign for them, and John Turp, man. I mean, there's a Sanic and a Knuckles. You could talk to one of them. I mean, they're right there. Oh, Everdred stopped playing. He stopped playing ball. And Sanic thinks Floofy Scorp is okay. And she is just, she is owning this challenge so far. Well, it's not really a challenge. If I've said challenge before, I did not mean it. This is just an event. It's a happy, fun time Sanic and Knuckles event. Look, they're actually discussing Floofy Squirp down here. Oh, and I think Sanic... Sanic pissed himself. Well, you know, he also, now he smells bad and has nowhere to bathe. I really don't want people, you know, I was going to add a toilet and let people piss, but fuck it. I'm just going to leave it as is. This is how I built it. I'm not going to change things. If I add a toilet, then people won't have a chance to be embarrassed in front of Sanic and Knuckles, so let's do it. Let's just leave the bathroom out of it. People will just have to squat behind a tree if they don't want to be embarrassed. Floofy filled up on sugary goodness. That improved her mood. Somebody in this group has unresolved issues. Uh-oh. Somebody wants to go home already. That's when that message pops up, that's usually what that means. It looks like the maid's done something good. John Turp. He was having a bad day earlier today. He's the one with the lowest mood. Oh, he has to pee. Well, John Turp, I'm so sorry, but you're... IJ's not here anymore for you to pee in front of, as the IRC folks seem to notice. He had a habit of pissing in front of Internet Janitor. I don't know why, but he did. Yeah, it looks like he's gonna have to pee in front of somebody else today, perhaps Sanic or Knuckles. So yeah, Knuckles, he's kicking that hairdo there. They're all yelling at John Turp! What's going on here? And who's Everdread calling? Maybe he's calling a porta potty company. Everybody, all they can talk about is toilets and John Turp. For some reason. Whoops, I looked at the wrong thing. He doesn't have to pee. That's his hygiene meter that's low. Everybody's hygiene meter is going to be low. Although, I think Everdread's going to piss himself. Yeah, he's gonna here in just a few minutes. Well, we're here until 9 p.m., guys. Unless you guys decide to leave early, I'm going to go ahead and fast forward here. There's not too much going on. Oh, and yes, someone urinated. Looks like Everdread. And I think Knuckles is going to go right on top of his. This is what happens. Oh, and Noemi, it just went. This is what parties are, you know? You go to a party with Sanic and Knuckles, and everybody just pisses their pants. That's what you do. That's what I'd do if I went to a party with them. I'd be like, hey, Knuckles, come here, I have a secret to tell you. I have to piss really bad. And then I just piss right then and there. Just piss in my pants. And then I just, like, look at him and point down at my crotch, where it's just becoming sopping wet from urine. And Knuckles would give me a thumbs up with his big, spiky... Knuckles, and we'd laugh and have a good time. That's what a Sanic and Knuckles party is. It's a pissing party. Alright. I went a little too far with that, I think. Noemi has been spending a lot of time at the bookstore and has read 5 unique books. I don't know if that's going to do her any good later or not. Now, we got about an hour and a half left of Sanic and Knuckles time. Nobody's left. Nobody's been kicked out. Someone else pissed themselves, I think. And it is 8:30. Still everybody? Everybody's here. Looks like we've actually had some more people join in on the fun. I don't know who this is. Malcolm Landgrob. That's Malcolm? Nice hair, Malcolm. It looks like he's like a teenager or something. Or is it a woman named Malcolm? I don't think so. I think that's a man. I don't know. All I do know is that we have 8 minutes, 7 minutes left in this Sanic and Knuckles party, and Noemi is wasting it away by reading. I think Floofy is probably going to come out on top here. 9 p.m. It is 9 p.m. The party is over. Time for everyone to go home. They had a nice day with Sanic and Knuckles, but all good things, sadly, must come to an end. So, let's go ahead and cancel all their stuff and have them head out. So, hooray. As you can see, Sanic and Knuckles really like sliding down slides and going around loop-de-loops and running on treadmills. That's kind of their thing. So they don't have bathrooms, though. They just go in the Angel Island zone, the Mushroom Hill zone, whatever you want to call it. They just kind of pee in the wild because they're wild creatures. They're hedgehog, or they're hog hedges and dick hednas. So that's how that works. All right. Everyone has made their way home. Once they actually get in here and their little go home thing goes away, then we'll check out these relationships. All right, let's take a look here. Now, people are probably going to split off here in a second and do their things, you know, take showers, take a piss, whatever. But let's check these relationships. So remember, like I said, let's check for the Sanic one first. So the person with Sanic highest on their list, not counting acquaintances, and as we can see in Everdreads, we don't have any of those. Although, for some reason, Turdbot's up here. But you can see his meter is clearly way down here. Maybe it's because they're separated by a boundary now? Don't know. I mean, maybe if I unpause it for a second, it'll move. I don't know. I've been trusting this thing since the beginning. I'm going to continue to trust it. I don't get that, but let's just take a look and see where Sanic is. Sanic is third from the bottom here. Okay, let's check out John Terp. Where's Sanic? He doesn't even have Sanic. He doesn't even have Knuckles. John Terp. No, he didn't even talk to him. Amazing. Everybody has Turdbot on the left side. What's up with that? Huh. Maybe if we just, I don't know. Okay, let's check Floofy. Oh yeah, she has Sanic way up there. And Knuckles is at the very bottom. Is she the first one with the Knuckles? No. Looks like Everdread is number one with Knuckles at number five. So Everdread, she's got him fourth from the left. Did Noemi talk to Sanic? Nope. Noemi has Knuckles, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So Noemi and Everdread, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, seem to be tied with Knuckles. And Floofy has clearly won the Sanic friendship competition, I guess. Would be what that's called. So let's go ahead and give her her prize for being best friends out of everyone with Sanic. There is actually a special little hack here. So if I have Floofy selected and I shift click the mailbox, I can click make all happy, and that will increase all of her little bars down here, as we can see as we unpause it. It'll make them all go all the way up. That is actually a pretty good prize, honestly. That's a real good prize. The Knuckles prize, however, is basically those who have Knuckles on the highest on their list get a permanent bathroom with a toilet and a shower just for them. It's locked to everyone but them. So I'm going to go ahead and build that now, really quickly. So, Everdread, I think, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And Noemi. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Looks like they both got Knuckles, so they're both going to have exclusive access to this bathroom. And like I said, this might not make a real big difference in the grand scheme of things, but it might. So I'm just going to go ahead and build it for them. It's going to be a super rinky-dink little bathroom, but that's okay. All they really need is just a shower and a toilet and a door locked to everyone but them. So let's go ahead and do that. It's not going to be a nice bathroom by any means. We're not going to decorate it. We're just going to throw this thing together real quick and just slap any old crappy door on it. Like, nah, we don't want one with a window. Hey, this one works. Can't put it there? Then I'll put it there. And then let's go ahead and get our bathroom crap here. We'll give them a fancy one. How about that? They'll have access to fancy stuff. So we'll give them, like, the most expensive toilet. And we'll give them the most expensive shower. Oh, yeah, it's like a double thing. We'll go ahead and put some lighting in there so they can actually see when they bathe themselves. What do we got here? There's this one. Yeah, I like this one because it looks kind of... it looks like it would kind of fit in a shitty beach campground type deal. Yeah, I'm not going to wallpaper this thing. Not going to do anything else to it. We're not going to get crazy here. I don't want to spend too much time building this. So let's lock this to everybody, but... can I do that? Can I lock it to everybody but Noyemi and Everdred? Everyone but her? Oh, I don't think I can. Specify Sims. Let's do that. So Noyemi and Everdred. They have exclusive access to this this bathroom. Let's make sure it has a roof. Yeah, it does. Okay, good. All right, cool. That was quick and easy. Got that set up. Now you guys have your very own special place. Can't really share it, but you can both use it. They both have access to it. So there we go. So that was the Sanic and Knuckles event. Hope that was exciting for you. And now we have a challenge day coming up. Day 10 here in a couple hours will be Tuesday. And we will have a challenge at noon, actually. We've decided to start this at noon this time. So we're going to go ahead and fast forward here. Looks like everybody's in pretty good mood. And I can't say I'm really surprised. Look at this. Look at these. Oh, I better get off that relationship tab. Look at these relationships building here. These people, they are enjoying each other's company. They're talking to each other. They're building relationships. They are building alliances. They are trying to get a vote because votes are important here. Immunity gnomes are important as well. I don't actually remember who has an immunity gnome at this point. I'm not going to check. My memory sucks. I'm going to take a drink here real quick. My memory sucks. You've probably, if you know me in real life or if you've chatted with me in IRC, you probably know somehow, for some reason, I just have a really bad memory. And so, honestly, I could not tell you who has an immunity gnome. I could guess, but I'm probably wrong. So, I know for a fact Noyemi doesn't, right? Maybe? I don't think she does. Yeah, see, my memory sucks. Anyway, let's go ahead and fast forward here. We're looking for Tuesday at noon to do this challenge. It should be an exciting one. Should be kind of interesting. I've never really run a full test on it, so it shouldn't be deadly. I'm almost positive it's not going to be deadly, actually. if it is, then that would suck, but... it should be pretty simple. Simple setup, but a good test. And there's actually kind of a good reason that I set it up for noon instead of, you know, bright and early at 8 in the morning. It looks like these Sims know what they're doing now. I mean, they're just, you know, these are experienced veteran Something Awful Game Dev Survival Challenge Sims. They know what they're doing. They know that they need to get as much rest as possible. They know they need to pee as much as possible. You know, they need to keep their mood up as much as they can. Everdred apparently thinks he lost a friend. I don't know who that would be. John Turp is still anxious to advance. I mean, that's just too bad. We're not giving people jobs in this run, so maybe that's why he's in a bad mood. That's actually pretty horrible. Wait, Noyemi lost a friend too. Did she and Everdred have like a falling out? I know they were talking a lot. Oh, that's sad. But not really, because this is a challenge. Friends are all that matter. And if you can't make friends, you're going to get voted off. Look, John Turp's waking up and trying to steal votes from these two women while Everdred sleeps away peacefully. Bold move, John Turp. I still love Everdred's nighttime garments. Well, they're all four talking. This is what we like to see. We like to see relationships happening. We don't care about that stuff. Things are probably going to be moving quite a bit faster as time goes on, especially as the number of contestants dwindles down. Just because there's less stuff to take care of, and, you know, we really don't care about the people in the Exile Tower. What's Floofy doing? What are you doing, Floofy? Viewing a gnome. This is how Floofy passes her time. Just kind of stands there, you know, just checking out that gnome, thinking about music. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool looking gnome there, isn't it? I mean, I think it's pretty exciting. It's Oh my God. That, well, hey, maybe that's why she was watching them. She was waiting for them to move and so that she could cheer them on. And now she's going to go eat leftover hot dogs. Sounds good, Floof. We have 1 hour remaining until the next challenge. The maid's not going to be able to win this one. I can tell you that. If she does, then holy shit, that would be, I'd be very doubly super impressed. Looks like I just grasped the basics of cooking. Cooking might actually come into play later on. As we get further into the challenge, you know, skills might actually make a difference. It's noon. Time to set up the next challenge. Now, our contestants just got to meet Sanic and Knuckles. And while they were talking to Sanic and Knuckles, they were inspired by their athletic ability and their ability to gotta go fast. Gotta bust walls, gotta climb walls, gotta go fast. They were super inspired by this. So they requested. These Sims actually, you know, looked at me and broke the fourth wall and requested that I set up a challenge for them that is inspired by Sanic the Hoghedge and Knuckles the Dickhedna. And I said, you know what? I do it just for you guys. You guys are so special to me. I will set up this amazing challenge based on your favorite video game characters. So let's go and do that. So first of all, oh man, what am I looking for? I'm looking for exercise stuff. Where would I find exercise stuff? Electronics maybe? Oh, here we go, entertainment. And this is what I'm looking for, the shut-in treadmill. Now we have 4 contestants left, which means we need 4 treadmills. So let's set these up like so. 4 treadmills. And we also need, excuse me, 4 comfy outdoor chairs directly across from the treadmill. Let's actually move that a little bit closer. There we go. Okay. Now, this challenge is not designed to trap Sims in, at least not once it gets started. The challenge is, and this is going to sound super simple, and I kind of designed it that way on purpose, but it's going to be fun anyway. The challenge is the Gotta Go Fast challenge. So each Sim is going to start seated in these chairs. They're going to start napping. So let's go ahead and get that set up. So let's cancel what they're doing and have them nap in one of these chairs. Get John Turp over here and Everdred. He's using the bathroom. We'll get him over here. Okay. Once everyone's there, we'll just do a little fast forward. And once they all have Z's coming out of their heads, this may look very familiar here. Okay, we are going to all at once instruct the Sims to use the treadmills. That's all I'm going to do. I'm just going to say use the treadmill. The last Sim to stop using the treadmill gets an immunity gnome. It's that simple. The Sim who lasts the longest on the treadmill gets an immunity gnome. So I'm going to go ahead and instruct them to get on those treadmills and get up off the ass. And we will start this and see who gets the next immunity gnome. So the trick here is going to be energy and athletics, I believe. Those are going to be the relevant abilities. So let's see if I can get a good camera angle here without having shit get in the way. There, this looks pretty good. This looks pretty good. It's right in the middle. We've got the nice scenic view of the ocean and a toilet in the background. It's perfect, right? So yeah, super simple setup. Let's get this started. I'm going to hit go. And they're going to start working out. Maybe. Here they go. Of course, they change into their athletic outfits. And away they go. So the last person to stop you. Oh, Noemi. Oh, damn. Oh, Everdred. Everybody's just, they're dropping like flies out here. Ah, somebody's never used a treadmill before. Oh, shit, Floofy. Oh, John Terp's the only one who hasn't fallen. Look, he's just treading. Oh, there he goes. I was going to say, he's just treading away. Now, I wonder if... they're falling nonstop. I wonder if falling affects their relationship with nearby Sims. That'd be cool if it did. It, like, made them actually embarrassed. So, yeah, this could go on for quite a long time, I think. Again, I haven't done a real test of this because I didn't want to, like, spoil it for myself. But I have taken four random Sims and just made sure that they'd get on these and it would last at least a little time. I'm pretty sure that this is based on mainly energy. But I think since I've only directed them to exercise, if they have to do other things, like pee, those will take priority. So... looks like Everdred might be at a loss here, because he was in the middle of pissing when I brought him over. John Terp also has to piss. Floofy Scorp also has to piss. Everybody has to piss. So this is actually going to be kind of a close call, I think. Everybody's going to get some athletic skill. That's fine. Looks like Noemi is actually hungry as well. There goes the maid. Yeah, so this could be anybody's game, actually. Anybody could win this. I love that they're falling like 5 million times. This is great. Oh. Wow. Okay, well, let's fast forward this a little bit. Oh! Oh! Uh-oh! Looks like two people could not hold it. John Terp and Floofy are both out of the competition. Oh! Oh my god! I did not expect this! It looks like Noemi just stopped. Everdred just won! The gotta go fast! Something awful. Game dev survival. Challenge, challenge. And he's still going! And he just stopped. And now everyone has to take a long hard piss. That was not what I expected. Everdred. I did not expect that one single bit. I figured he would have to go pee first, especially since I pulled him off the toilet to come do this competition. Well, let's give him his immunity gnome. Let's see. I think it's debug by. Right? No? Okay, then it's by debug. Dat bad memory. At least I know where to go to get the stupid thing. Here we go. Stick that right there. Make sure we're on Everdred. Go to his inventory. He actually already has an immunity gnome. He has two now. Oh, what an advantage. Everdred, holy shit. Everdred might have this competition locked up tight. Let's go ahead and get rid of this stuff. They don't need this anymore. That was probably one of the simpler challenges that we will have on this show. I definitely did not expect Everdred to win that. All right. Well, I guess all that's left. This might be also close to record setting for one of the fastest episodes as well. So let's go ahead and go to voting time. We'll go to 9 p.m. here, and as long as nothing explodes or nobody dies or what have you, then we'll have our nightly vote. So let's do that. So it looks like it's 4 o'clock. We got about 5 hours left. Everdred just took advantage of his private restroom. What's this? This door is unlocked, is it not? Okay, good. And they're having a little protest out here in front of the bathroom. What's going on? Chewbacca. Let's keep fast forwarding here. No, we don't care about that stuff. Looks like Everdred's going to play with the Noemi releasing ball with Floofy Scorp. And Noemi is going to go use her own private bathroom. Look at that. See, it does make a difference. Noemi gets to use her private shower while, I believe John Terp uses the public one. So it did come in handy. I imagine that toilet will come in handy too. Oh, she even cleaned up after herself. How about that? All right, let's go until 9 p.m. here. We've got a couple hours left. Night has fallen. Oh, don't care about that stuff. 8 o'clock. Everdred is viewing a gnome. What's going on with Fluffy? What was she doing? Mop up puddle. Oh, she has no room to mop it up, so... Sorry, Fluffy. I made the bathroom too small, I know. My bad. 8:30, 8:40, 8:50. And it's almost voting time. 9 p.m. Let's get people coming over to this voting area. I feel like I'm running a little bit tighter of a ship here. Although, it's also kind of sad. With less Sims, there's less to talk about. There's less for me to comment on. There's less people pissing themselves now. It's kind of depressing. I kind of liked it when people peed all the time. As weird as that sounds, it just was more interesting. But hey. This is the Something Awful Game Dev Survival Challenge. We don't care if it's boring. We don't pay bills. We don't care what the repo man took. We're here to survive. And that's it. To survive and to vote. Come on up the stairs, ladies. There we go. Everyone is soundly resting. And now we will take our vote. Let's start with Everdred. Everdred, who will you vote into the Exile Tower? Drumroll. No, can't be Santa Chronicles, can't be Johnny Five Aces, can't be that woman, can't be Turdbot, can't be me because I'm already in there. Who's it going to be but John Turp? One vote for John Turp from Everdred. Floofy, who are you going to vote for? Floofy is going to vote for... Can't be me, can't be Turdbot, can't be Sanic. Another John Turp. Oh, man. John Turp. The one who didn't make any friends at the Sanic and Knuckles event. Let's see what John Turp has to say about this. John Turp, who are you going to vote for? John Turp. No, no, no. Can't be Turdbot or me. He's going to vote for Floofy. Interesting. Floofy. One vote for her. If Noemi votes for Floofy, then we'll have a tie. It doesn't look like she did. Let's take a look here just to make sure. Can't be Knuckles. Can't be Turdbot. Can't be me. Wait, did I miss somebody? No, I didn't. Can't be me. She did! Oh, man. Noemi voted for Floofy. That means we have a tie. We have John Turp and Floofy against each other. Okay, well, let's do the needful here and check to see. Does John Turp have an immunity gnome? No, he does not. Does Floofy have an... she does not have an immunity gnome. Go figure. Go figure that John Turp is in another tiebreaker. Okay, well, remember the last tiebreaker was bullshit. All around bullshit. It was just horrible. So I've come up with a couple other ideas for what the tiebreakers could be. And some of them are actually really simple. And I don't know if I want to do this or not. So I've got a choice here. I could just look at their moods, and whoever has the highest mood meter will win. I could have them fish, but that might take a while. Because I kind of don't want to do that. No, I definitely don't want to do that. So mood meter, or we could take a look at a skill. But, I mean, most of their skills are going to be kind of weird. I mean, some of them don't actually have skills. So maybe we could, maybe we could look at their skills tab. Well, the other option is lifetime happiness points. So, okay. Our options are, we could look at their skills tab and tally up how many skills they have. Like how many bars are full. And whoever has the most bars wins. We could look at their lifetime happiness points and see who has the highest lifetime happiness, and they'll win. Or, there goes my bad memory again. What the hell did I say earlier? What was the first thing I said? we could have them, it wasn't fishing. Son of a... How is my memory that bad? I just said it like 5 minutes ago. That's too bad I don't have these written down or anything. Otherwise, you know, I'd know what I was doing. Mood. That's what it was. The mood meter. Okay, so let's pull out the old trusty nickel.
I'm gonna get my nickel here. I put it all the way back where it was, so I'm gonna have to get it all the way back out. Now, you know what? This nickel's gonna be such a pain to get out of where it was. How about we go to an online randomizer? How about that? We've got some time in this episode, right? Let me go ahead and add a, can I do this? Add a window capture. Could do to Google Chrome. Can you guys see that? I don't know if you can or not. It doesn't look like it's working. Let's delete that. Let's go ahead and open up this random selection, maybe random selection tool. Random choice. Yes, we can type in three items and have it pick for us. So let me try to add this one more time just so you guys can see it. Maybe I could do monitor capture and just do like a section of the monitor. Let's do that. Select region. Okay, it's right here, blah, blah, blah. Sorry about this. Hey, what the hell? I can't select it because it's down. Oh, there we go. Okay. Can you see this? Yes, you can. Excellent. So the choices were mood meter, lifetime happiness, skill point total. Your items are on separate lines. The box below, a random choice button. Randomly generated item from the list will appear in the box below. So here is our choice. Skill point total. There you go. All that work. All that work for that. So let's get rid of that. Okay. So, skill point total. Let's take a look here between Floofy Scorp and John Turp. Floofy Scorp has 1, 2. John Turp. 1, 2. Okay. Well, they tied there. Okay, so let's do the next one. Let's take a look at we're gonna have to let the random number thing do this, because if I pick one, it's gonna be biased. So hold on. Let me bring that back up. I totally closed Chrome because I thought we were finished. What's going on here? Why is it not letting me? Okay. One momento. Uno momento. Is it in my history? Because I don't want to search for it. It should be in there. Here we go. Random choice generator. Bada bing. Hey, how about that? It even still has my my choices. How cute. Okay. So, skill point total is not going to work. Let's see. Mood meter or lifetime happiness? Mood meter. Mood meter it is. We got this. Okay. Let's get rid of this weird, crazy stuff so it doesn't screw up our video. Mood meter. Who has the highest mood meter? John Turp. Now, there's no number here, but we can click between them and see if it's close. He's pretty high. Oh. Looks like Floofy Scorps is less. Let's flip back and forth. Yes. It looks like Floofy Scorps is less. So, Floofy Scorp, you've been voted off. Through a tiebreaker of very simple and random design, you are now being sent to the Exile Tower. So we'll unlock this. We'll unlock it. Actually, we'll just lock it for everyone but her. And we'll add a set of stairs, just like we always do. And send Floofy that way, and once she's in there, this episode will be done. We'll be good to go. So, Floofy, get in there with the rest of us. Haul ass in there with the rest of us. Get going. Okay, she's in there. We're gonna go ahead and lock this to everybody, which is not what I did in the past because I'm a dum-dum. We'll delete these stairs and call it an episode. So,
In this episode, we had an interesting time. We got to meet Sanic and Knuckles. We got to do a treadmill challenge, and now we have three people in the Exile Tower. We have Turdbot, we have me, and we have Floofy Scorp. What will happen next? Only time will tell in this Something Awful Game Development Survival Challenge. Let's go ahead and get these folks off the voting area. Man, Noyemi. She got back into the game, and she stayed in the game. She's not about to get voted off of this... voted into the Exile Tower again. She is not about that. Let's add these ropes back in. Rope fence. Alright. That's it. Pretty wholesome episode here. Had some good things happen. Got to make some new friends, and yeah. Things are going well. We're going to speed through this. We're going to get through the end of the season and find out who the winner is. Will it be Noyemi? Will it be John Terp? Or will it be the everlasting Everdread, who appears to have this challenge in his pocket? We will see. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.